हर खबर पर होगी आपकी पकड़। डाउनलोड कीजिए एबीपी लाइव ऐप।
वेल गुड आफ्टरनून एंड थैंक यू वेरी मच ऑल ऑफ यू फॉर कमिंग ओवर फॉर दिस प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस एट अ वेरी शॉर्ट नोटिस। मेनली वी विल फोकस ऑन टू इश्यूज। द फर्स्ट वन रिलेट्स टू द येस बैंक, वेयर एज यू नो द रिकंस्ट्रक्शन प्लान हैज ऑलरेडी बीन नोटिफाइड बाय द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया। And the second issue we will deal with is certain aspects related to the fallout of the coronavirus, the fallout of it on in India and its impact on the Indian economy. With regard to the Yes Bank, you would recall earlier that I had stated on Friday, which is 6th of March, that is the one day after the moratorium was announced, that the RBI will come out with scheme very swiftly and very quickly, and as you would have seen, swift action has been taken by the Reserve Bank of India and by the government. There has been very active coordination between the Government of India, the Finance Ministry and the Reserve Bank. If I can just recapitulate the dates, the moratorium was announced on Thursday, 5th of March. The very next day, 6th of March, the draft scheme was put out in the public domain, and the final scheme was notified again on the next Friday, that is between Friday and the next Friday on 13th of March. The final reconstruction scheme has been notified by the Government of India. The lifting of moratorium is taking place after three working days of putting the final scheme in, after notification of the final scheme, and that will be on Wednesday, 18th March at 6 p.m. The moratorium gets lifted, and the new board, as you would be aware from the notification, the new board will assume its position, and the administrator will office of the administrator will cease to exist on 26th of March. So as you can see, this has been a very swift and fast action, perhaps a record of a sort. With regard to the restructuring scheme which has been notified by the government, I would like to say that it is a very credible and sustainable restructuring plan. We do believe it is credible and it will sustain in the years to come. It is also an instance, perhaps the first of its type, it is also an instance of public-private partnership for revival of a private sector bank. Apart from the State Bank of India, you have leading private sector banks which are major stakeholders in the banking sector, both the public sector segment led by the State Bank of India and major private sector banks have joined hands to revive the Yes Bank and to take the restructuring scheme forward. In that way also, it is perhaps the first of its type. And in India, on earlier occasions, whenever there was failure of a scheduled commercial bank, the usual method has been amalgamation of the failed bank with a larger entity. This time we have not done so. This time the identity of the Yes Bank, the bank which is in difficulty, the identity of that bank is retained, and the investors are the banks which have come forward. So the participation of private sector banks in particular demonstrates the confidence of major players in the banking sector in the revival plan. So that is in this background, I would like to state a point which I have said earlier, which we had told in our press note also earlier, that the depositors' money is absolutely safe. I would take this opportunity through you to convey to all the depositors of Yes Bank that their money, their deposits with the Yes Bank are completely safe, and there is no reason for any undue worry, or there is no need for rushing into withdrawing their deposits or their money which is with the Yes Bank. Their money is safe. In India, if you go by history, never in the banking history of India, in a scheduled commercial bank, the depositors have never lost money. Their interests have always been protected. The present scheme also protects the interest of the depositors. So I once again reiterate that the depositors need not worry. Their money is safe after 6 p.m. on Wednesday, which is 18th of March. They can draw their money, but there is absolutely no reason for them, no need for them to go for panic withdrawal or for getting unduly worried. Their money continues to be safe. I am again and again saying this because this is very important, and the whole scheme, the underlying theme, the main point on which the scheme is based on, is to protect the interest of the depositors. And I also would like to say that two more points, especially in the light of action by certain authorities, especially at the state level, to taking decision to withdraw money from private sector banks. The Reserve Bank of India, from RBI, we have written to all state governments, impressing upon them that the Indian banking sector is sound and safe, and Indian banking sector includes the private sector banks. We have specifically indicated that the health of the banking sector, including the private banking sector, is sound and safe, and therefore there is no reason for state government authorities to withdraw deposits or to take deposits or to keep away from the private sector banks. Private sector banks are an important component of our banking sector, and therefore it would be necessary that in the interest of financial stability, in the interest of banking stability, that the various authorities, both at the central and at the state government level, they continue their confidence on the private sector banks. I am also happy to note that during all these months, when there were stories about Yes Bank having increasing difficulty, large number of depositors of Yes Bank have remained loyal, and they are still with the Yes Bank. I do expect and appeal to them to continue their confidence and loyalty to the Yes Bank. And you have the big names of Indian banking sector which are there participating in the revival plan for revival of the Yes Bank. And we have also, I think, the one next point I would like to mention is that the Yes Bank has enough liquidity to meet any requirement. If, I repeat, if there is a requirement, the Reserve Bank will provide necessary liquidity support to Yes Bank to meet its requirements if such a requirement arises. So that is a comforting factor for the depositors, that the Reserve Bank will support the Yes Bank with liquidity if it is required. And we are quite at this point of time, our interaction with the investing banks, the State Bank and the other private sector banks, our interaction with them gives us the confidence that the revival of Yes Bank will work out. It's a sound revival plan and it's a robust revival plan. So before I conclude this part relating to Yes Bank, I would again reiterate the depositors to remain confident that their money is safe. Now, coming to the COVID-19 outbreak, I would like to state as follows. The COVID-19 outbreak, now a pandemic according to the WHO, is rapidly evolving into a human tragedy, disrupting economic activity in a wide swath of affected countries. Financial markets across the world are experiencing intense volatility, and financial conditions have tightened worldwide. Policy authorities have responded with emergency measures, and more recently, advanced economies have coordinated large policy rate reductions with activation of swap lines as well as quantitative and credit easing. Tentative estimates of consequent loss of global growth are currently placed in the range of 0.4 to 1.5%. India is not immune to this pandemic. Already more than 100 cases have been reported. Efforts are being mounted by the government on a war footing to arrest the spread of coronavirus through social distancing, preventive measures, and by issuing health advisories. COVID-19 could impact economic activity in India directly through trade channels, especially in electronics, drugs, pharmaceuticals, chemicals, etc., in which the exposure to China is relatively high. Second round of effects of the pandemic could operate through a slowdown in the domestic economic growth. And it would obviously be a result of a side of a synchronized slowdown in global growth, and as a part of that, India, the growth momentum in India also would be impacted somewhat. How much? We're going into the monetary policy meeting. As and when it is held, we will take a clearer view of the impact of the global slowdown on the Indian economy. So I would like to say that the second round effects of pandemic could operate through the slowdown in global growth. Already sectors such as, I'm now talking about global as well as India, already sectors such as tourism, airlines, the hospitality industry and domestic trade and transport are suffering a loss of activity. More immediately, spillovers are being transmitted through finance and confidence channels to overseas and domestic equity markets. Forex and bond markets are also not immune to the current volatile conditions. There is considerable uncertainty about the duration of the pandemic, and the currently available estimates of its adverse effects will undergo sizable revisions if this coronavirus persists longer or if it gets contained much earlier than currently believed. It is important to ensure that policy reactions are carefully considered and calibrated so as to assuage sentiment and instill confidence. In this context, the Reserve Bank has been taking several calibrated measures over the past few days to ensure that financial markets and institutions remain sound and resilient, and also to build confidence more generally in the financial system. In fact, the lack of response to our 7-day repo auction of ₹25,000 crore, which was conducted on March 13th, has reassured us that domestic liquidity conditions remain comfortable. It is important that policy space is used appropriately and is suitably timed to optimize its impact. The RBI has several instruments at its command and stands ready. I repeat, the RBI has several policy instruments at its command and stands ready to take all necessary measures to ensure that the effects of COVID-19 pandemic on the Indian economy are mitigated and financial markets and institutions in India continue to function normally. The level of forex reserves, as you would be aware, remains comfortable to meet any exigency. Based on the current evaluation of domestic financial conditions, I propose to announce the following two measures. One, taking into account the favorable response to the sale by swap auctions conducted today and the evolving financial market conditions, we propose to conduct another 6 months US dollar sell by swap on March 23rd to provide liquidity to the foreign exchange market. The details of this are being notified separately. Two, in order to counterbalance the domestic liquidity effects of the swap and to further improve monetary transmission, I repeat, in order to counterbalance the domestic liquidity effects of the swap and to further improve monetary transmission, the RBI will conduct long-term repo operations, LTRO, in multiple tranches of appropriate sizes up to a total amount of ₹1 lakh crores at the policy, and this will be done at the policy rate. This will be followed by a review of the performance of our LTRO. Details relating to LTROs are being announced separately. Another point before I conclude, I would like to mention in the context of COVID-19 is that, as you are aware, the RBI and the government together, we are giving lot of emphasis on, you know, in encouraging digital payments. And over a period of time, various measures have been taken to establish safe, secure, affordable retail payment systems like the NEFT, the immediate payment service system which we have, that is the IMPS, UPI, then the Bharat bill payment systems, etc. In times like this, when the health authorities, when government has announced to minimize social contact, to minimize visiting of crowding places which are crowded, it may be a good idea to use digital modes of payment for carrying out various transactions, for purchase of, you know, wherever cash payments are involved. Because for cash payment, you need to visit a market, you need to visit a crowded area. But when you use more of digital payments, there is no need for going to a shop, there is no need for, you know, visiting a crowded marketing place. So we have also advised the banks in a circular which we have issued some little while ago today to encourage more and more of digital payments. So to conclude the portion, the segment relating to coronavirus, I would like to say two measures which we have announced today. They are based on our assessment of the current situation. RBI has several policy instruments at its disposal. We will use the various policy instruments from time to time depending on requirement, and our response will be calibrated. Our effort is to see that our responses are neither premature nor delayed. We will make every effort to see that whatever instrument or whatever announcements, policy announcements we make, they do have the desired effect, they do have optimum impact. Thank you very much. If there are few questions, because I think I would request that if we can limit the number of questions, we are all under pressure of time, so we could take a few questions.
सभी लोग उम्मीद कर रहे थे कि आप एक रेट कट करेंगे जो आप घोषणा नहीं कर रहे हैं. क्या वजह है उस फैसले के पीछे? काफी सारे सेंट्रल बैंक्स ने पॉलिसी मीटिंग के पहले रेट कट किए हैं, लेकिन आप ये संकेत दे रहे हैं कि वो फैसला पॉलिसी मीटिंग में ही होगा, तो ये क्या देर नहीं हो जाएगी?
नहीं, मैंने ऐसा नहीं कहा कि वो फैसला, हाँ, पॉलिसी मीटिंग में ही होगा. वो तो लॉ इज लाइक दैट. आरबीआई एक्ट में प्रोविजन है कि जो रेट, रेपो रेट का जो डिसीजन है वो एमपीसी में लिया जाएगा. लेकिन मैं आपको, आई डोंट रूल आउट एनीथिंग, आई एम नॉट रूलिंग आउट एनी पॉसिबिलिटी. So therefore, I did say yes, the MPC will take a decision, but I don't rule out anything, because depending on the evolving situation, we will decide on the timing of our action.
To the Indian economy from COVID-19, you mentioned a figure of 0.4 to 1.5% on the global economy. Do we have any number in mind right now? And I understand this will change as the situation evolves, but to your mind, what is the impact we can look at?
You see, that's what I said. We are making we are estimating it. As and when the MPC meeting is held, we will give out the numbers, our estimate. And so far as Indian economy is concerned, I think the fact that India is relatively insulated from the, you know, global value chain, to that extent the impact on India will be less. But India is integrated, integrated to the global economy, so there will be some impact. We are evaluating it and we will announce it when we hold the policy meeting, MPC meeting, we will announce it at that time.
सर ब्रजेश फ्रॉम जी बिजनेस. सर एक सवाल ये है कि जो मेजर्स, जो स्कीम अनाउंस की गई है यस बैंक के लिए, उसमें सर ये है कि जो लॉक इन लगाया गया है 3 साल का, उसमें ये है कि 100 शेयर के ऊपर भी है तो भी लॉक इन लागू होगा. उसमें सर बहुत सारे जो रिटेल इन्वेस्टर्स हैं, म्यूचुअल फंड्स की पोजीशंस हैं, वो इम्पैक्ट होंगी. तो क्या इस पर सेबी से या इसको सेबी से बातचीत हुई थी, उनको भरोसे में लिया गया था?
इसी सरकार में जब फैसला लिया जाता है, जो रेलिवेंट एजेंसीज है उनके साथ डिस्कशंस होता है. और ये जो आपने कहा लॉक इन के बारे में कहा, ये जो स्कीम का मेन प्रायोरिटी है स्कीम का अंडरलाइंग प्रायोरिटी जो मेन प्रायोरिटी है, एक तो बैंक का रिवाइवल, यस बैंक का रिवाइवल, और नंबर टू, इनफैक्ट द फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज प्रोटेक्शन ऑफ डिपॉजिटर्स इंटरेस्ट। डिपॉजिटर का जो पैसा है उसको प्रोटेक्ट करना जरूरी है, और ये बैंक, इसीलिए वो बैंक का रिवाइवल बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट है। और ये ऑब्जेक्टिव अचीव करने के लिए कुछ सारे स्टेप्स लिए गए हैं ये अपने रिकंस्ट्रक्शन स्कीम के अंदर। सो ऑल एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ द रिकंस्ट्रक्शन स्कीम आर बेसिकली टुवर्ड्स अचीविंग दोज ऑब्जेक्टिव। और क्योंकि मैं हिंदी में बोल रहा हूं अभी, तो इस मतलब मैं ये भी कहना चाहूंगा यस बैंक के सारे डिपॉजिटर्स को कि आपका जो पैसा है यस बैंक में वो सेफ है, चिंता की कोई विषय नहीं है, वो एब्सोल्यूटली सेफ है।
सर एक सवाल और, पीएमसी बैंक के लिए, सर
एक मिनट, नो सेकेंड क्वेश्चन प्लीज, बिकॉज आई हैव टू गिव चांस टू अदर। नो आई एक मिनट, मैं सिस्टमेटिकली हम जाते हैं, आई विल कम फ्रॉम, यस या इसी आई एज एंड वेन डिसीशन ऑन एनी एस्पेक्ट इज टेकन वी विल अनाउंस इट। सो एट द मोमेंट आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू यू नो आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू सॉर्ट ऑफ टॉक अबाउट समथिंग ऑन विच डिसीशन हैज नॉट येट बीन टेकन।
सर आई वॉन्टेड टू नो हाउ विल यू एंश्योर वंस द मोरेटोरियम इज लिफ्टेड दैट देर इज नॉट अ रन ऑन द बैंक, एंड वाई इज येस बैंक मोरेटोरियम इज लिफ्टेड एंड वाई नॉट पीएमसी बैंक्स?
दोनों का सिचुएशन अलग अलग है, दोनों का अलग अलग लीगल फ्रेमवर्क है, तो दोनों को मतलब हम वन टू वन कंपेयर नहीं कर सकते हैं, और दोनों का जो एक्चुअल प्रिवेलिंग सिचुएशन है वो अलग अलग है, उसको हम कंपेयर नहीं कर सकते हैं।
सर दिस इज अमन सैयद फ्रॉम एएनआई। मेरा सवाल है सर कि फॉर्मर फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर पी चिदम्बरम ने आरबीआई पे सवाल खड़े किए हैं, जिस तरह 2014 से लेकर 2019 के बीच में लोन बुक्स में बढ़त हुई है, उन्होंने आंकड़े भी दिए, तो क्या आप उस पर रिएक्ट करना चाहेंगे? उन्होंने आंकड़े भी दिए 2014 में 55,633 करोड़।
देखिए कोई भी पॉलिटिकल मतलब कोई भी पॉलिटिकल ऑब्जर्वेशन के ऊपर या कोई भी पॉलिटिकल पर्सनालिटी के जो ऑब्जर्वेशंस आते हैं उसके ऊपर हम कुछ कहना नहीं चाहेंगे। आई थिंक आई विल आस्क आवर डिप्टी गवर्नर टू रिप्लाई टू दिस क्वेश्चन।
अंडर द बैंक रेगुलेशन एक्ट आरबीआई कैन आइदर डू एन अमलगमेशन और अ स्कीम ऑफ रिकंस्ट्रक्शन। ओके, वी इवैल्यूएट द एडवांटेजेस ऑफ अमलगमेशन एंड एडवांटेजेस ऑफ रिकंस्ट्रक्शन and came to the conclusion in this case that reconstruction is a better option.
Can you elaborate what was the reasons why you decided on reconstruction rather than amalgamation?
We found that that is a more viable way to do it.
Any reasons you can, I mean, anything?
It's more viable, that's it. Viable is viable.
It's more viable.
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah. Ankur Mishra from Financial Express. I wanted to ask question on Yes Bank, that it was disclosed in their results that there was discussion with RBI on invoking PCA. So should we understand that it will not be invoked, or what was the discussion?
अभी तो revival plan आ गया, तो PCA मतलब कहाँ से आता है?
Sir, it was mentioned in the auditor's note that since their capital is quite low, this 0.6% CET1, so there is a risk of invoking PCA by the regulator. However, they are in touch with regulator for the same. So should we understand that PCA will not be invoked in case of Yes Bank?
नहीं, अभी PCA invoke करने का कोई plan नहीं है। अभी जो capital infusion हुआ है 10,000 करोड़ का, the 10,000 crore rupees 10,000 crore capital infusion which has happened. It is adequate. It ensures compliance with regulatory requirements like the net NPA and capital adequacy. So, Avi, there is no such plan to invoke PCA in the case of Yes Bank.
Some result. I mean, all the parameter, right from you know equity, you know to you know gross NPAs to net worth. So, why PCA was not invoked?
You see, when we deal with, I think, such level of such micro issues as to why this was done, why this was not done. You see, we take a larger view of things, and we cannot apply various measures in a very mechanical manner. We have to take a larger call. At the first sign of stress in a bank, we cannot be using a hammer. So therefore, and let me assure you that over the last 7 to 8 months, the situation in Yes Bank was being monitored almost every day, and we decided to act when we thought it was appropriate time. I think we'll take two more questions and then we'll quote.
Sir, the depositors have complained that they have been missold the 81 bonds, and now they have lost all their deposits because they've been missold the bonds. So, are all the bonds going to be written off completely as per the scheme?
I think the bank has decided, and they have intimated the stock exchange that 81 bonds they are writing down. That is as per the terms of contract. That is as per the terms of contract between the Yes Bank and the investors.
Was there a situation
in between of? No, I can't.
Governor, just one question.
8 minutes. I think we need to conclude. There will be two or three more. I'll go from this side. Yes. No. I'll come to you. Yes. Yeah.
In February 2019, RBI had given a clearance in terms of divergence for Yes Bank.
Yeah.
In November 2019, you came out with a report saying that the divergence is only 3,700 crores. In 4 months, we look at a gross NP of 40,000 crores. Where did RBI slip, or what did RBI miss in these 4 months? Was RBI behind the curve?
Would you like to reply to that question?
One thing I would like
loudly,
to clarify.
I don't know. Is it picking up?
Yes.
One thing
I would like to clarify that as part of our supervision, we identify the divergences which are not in compliance with our regulatory guidelines. Any subsequent divergences or slippages to NPA as per IRAC norms, bank is supposed to do it. And that is what they have done it. As on 31st March 2019, only 3,000 crore divergences were observed which were not in compliance with IRAC norms.
Okay, I just take two more questions because we have some other meeting coming up. Yes, please, Cogencies.
Yeah. Sir, Bijoy from Cogencies, sir. Is there a risk, and I'm going back to the COVID-19, considering how much the interest differential between the advanced economies and India has become, is there really that much of a risk of foreign flight of capital or whatever that we have not moved yet on interest rates? Is there any particular reason why you all have chosen to save your gunpowder for later rather than moving now when it could have been seen as part of a much more coordinated global action?
I think that would be a giveaway. A reply to that question would be a giveaway. But in all seriousness, you see, it's a complexity of factors. So therefore, I can assure you that our endeavor is to sort of use the various instruments at the right time. Yes, Ritu, there.
What are the few steps you'd recommend the government take to insulate the economy from the impact of COVID? And two, on Yes Bank, many in the industry are of the view that the situation could have been handled without a moratorium if you had large investors on board, if you were willing to give concessions of the pricing on capital gains tax. So what is the guarantee that on Wednesday, as someone asked, that there will not be a run on the bank again? How will you prevent that?
You see, with regard to the COVID and what action the government will take, government is fully seized of the matter. I think they are working, they are acting on war footing, and government has also initiated, the steps being taken by government are known to you. It's in the public domain. I don't have to repeat that. From our side, if there are any suggestions, as I have said earlier, we will convey it directly to the government. And with regard to moratorium, I would request DG Vishwanath.
As we had mentioned in the press release when the moratorium was imposed, and Governor also said in the with the press when he met the subsequent day, our effort was to find a bank-led, private investor-led solution to address this bank. Yeah. However, when that did not happen, we had to use the scheme. The conditions on which they were willing to come, that was not within the domain of RBI. We can make a scheme which enables RBI to the government to have a scheme which overpowers many of the other provisions of the law and other laws. Okay, number one. Number two, if you look at the BR Act, the BR Act requires that a moratorium is a precondition for it drawing up a scheme. RBI could not have drawn up a scheme under Section 45 prior to a moratorium being imposed.
So I think thank you very much. Please kindly excuse. Excuse me, sir. You know, as you know, I have been extremely patient in MPC, in MPC press conferences. In the forthcoming MPC, we will provide the clarifications just once this part is over, because we have got another important meeting through, you know, video conference coming up, and for which we need to go back. And thank you very much for, I'm sorry I'm not able to take all questions, but thank you very much for coming over at a short response. Two points, once again, I would like to reiterate. First is that we do believe, and the investing banks, including SBI and the leading private sector banks, all of us believe that this is a credible revival plan for Yes Bank, and it will work. And the depositors should remain confident that their money is safe.
So with that, and
number two, I would like to say, with regard to the fallout of coronavirus, its impact on the global economy and the impact on India, the RBI, as I said, I repeat myself, the RBI stands ready to take whatever action is required at the appropriate time to have maximum impact. Thank you very much.
ABP News, aapko rakhe aage.
News channel itihas ki sabse badi series.
Pradhan Mantri Series 2, शनिवार रात 10 बजे